Now close your eyes. The mind feels there is an I. The mind knows there is an I. Oh, there's a problem in my eye. Okay? So I am not able to see. My glasses are not there. Who says that? Mind. Thought. Thought is the second seer. Mind is the second seer. Seer number one is I. Seer number two is mind. Right? Now who is the real seer? No, consciousness we have not gone. Okay? So the first level seer is the eyes. The second level seer is the mind. Now mind is able to see the eyes also. That's why eyes are not real seers. Mind is the seer. Eye is an object. Okay? Others what you see? Hey, nam nodde kane avana ara nam kanne nanu. So I nodde nanu andre nan I become the seer with the eyes. But that's not the real seer. That's a third level seer. So from third level seer, you go to second level seer. Now you feel the eyes. Who feels the eyes? Mind. So mind is the second level seer. Eyes are the? Not seer. Mithya, object. Okay? So now sit silently. Oh, no thoughts are in the mind. That is mind only. But I am aware that there are no thoughts in the mind. Who is aware? Sakshi. Right? That's the witness. From the seer number 3, you have to go to seer number 2. From seer number 2, you have to go to seer number 1. Now, who is the real seer?
Sakshi.
Huh? Number 3, awareness. Are we clear?
Yes.
So now, how many seers are there?
One.
Number 2 and number 3, they are dummy. They are not real. There's only one seer, that's called Sakshi. Right? And who sees the Sakshi? Nobody. Nobody can see the seer. Never in your life you can see your eyes. You can see your eyes only in mirror, reflection. Sakshi is the seer of everything, but nobody can see Sakshi. And I am that Sakshi. I am that witness. And that, who is it? Sakshi. The third level, awareness. Awareness.
There is nobody there.
No. Nobody can see, no? Awareness. See, there's no point in saying. See, you say, I am seeing. I am seeing the wall. So that's a thought. I am aware that I am seeing the wall is Sakshi. I am aware that I am seeing, I am aware of seeing the Sakshi, there's no meaning. There's nobody, one more level.
Sir, I am awareness also is a thought.
No, see, the awareness is a non-verbal understanding. But how to tell you? For telling, I have to verbalize you, no? Otherwise, I can just sit. So, you don't know whether I'm sleeping or meditating or samadhi or. So, I have to tell you, no? How to. So, I am aware that there is a pain in the body. That awareness is the light of the self, Atma the Lavedaku. Who can see Atma? Nobody. Who can see the Absolute? Nobody. But Absolute can see as Sakshi everything. What? So, a very simple three-step process. From the world, become aware of the eyes. From the eyes, you become aware of the mind. From mind, you become aware of awareness. Very simple from outer to inner journey. Any complexities? No? So your question is, awareness is embedded in me. No. You are embedded in awareness. Solle kathe hodiri. What? As long as you are awareness, fine. Are you aware or not aware? Okay, the question was a good question. What do you do if mosquito bites you? What is the answer?
Skin is the skin is the
first. I will tell you what Buddha did. Okay? When the mosquito bites us, Buddha also, no? Buddha, mosquito doesn't know he's a Buddha. Right? So Buddha knows it's a mosquito. Okay? So Buddha was going with Ananda, his disciple. So he walked some time. Okay? Then came back. First he did like this. Then he walked some time and came back like this. Then again did like this. Ananda asked him, Buddha, what happened to you? You took two steps forward and came back, again did like this. Okay? So Buddha said, there was a mosquito sitting on my cheek. I chased it away. Yeah, but then why did you come back? Then Buddha said, first time mosquito sat there, I chased it away in unawareness. Okay? I came back and chased it away, this time in awareness. Any action I do in awareness. So whatever you do, chase mosquito, chase girls, chase whiskey, whatever is happening, awareness. Awareness is important. What you chase, I don't know.
So girls will also bite in awareness.
So, say, do whatever you do in awareness. That's why morning walk when we went to awareness walk. Just be aware of your feet. Okay? In your life, bring more and more awareness to what you do. Right? So, I'll show you a small video. So see, just closely watch what that lady is doing. Thank you. going on? That is a Japanese deep preparation. Okay. So the lady is giving full awareness to every single action. Doing everything in total awareness. So when you do total awareness, the mind doesn't care at all. There's no mind state. In the no mind state, all actions, there's no doer, there's no individual. It becomes universal action. So the God operates through you in full awareness. So every couple of days, Japanese women do a tea ceremony, prepare a tea with full awareness. And that awareness, doing full awareness is the puja. Now let me ask you a question, very be sincere. Are you doing puja with awareness? Huh? When you do puja, do you do with awareness? Huh? Full awareness? Are you? So in puja, our ancestors said you to do full awareness. That's why they used the panchamrata, five elements. Okay, they used the light alarm so that you can full awareness. Put a flower, that smell is there. Put a agarbatti, light a lamp, and ring the bell. So that during puja time, bring awareness to the puja. Are you? Huh? Where is the mind? Paper banta, newspaper banta. ಅಲ್ಲ ಕಾಫಿ ರೆಡಿ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ರೀ ಹಾಲು ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಯ್ಯೋ ಇಷ್ಟು ದಿವಸ ಹಾಲು ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ ವೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಮೀ ಆರ್ ಯು ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಅವೇರ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಪೂಜಾ ಸೊ ದ ಜಪನೀಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಟೀ ಸೆರೆಮನಿ ಟೀ ಪ್ರಿಪರೇಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸರ್ವಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ದಿ ಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿಟ್ ಸೈಲೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ಎ ಕಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೀ ವಿತ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ The drinking of the tea becomes an offering to the God. Serving the tea becomes an offering to the God. Are you doing any such thing? My dear fellows, we only exported the technology to Japan. That's called Zen. Zen means dhyana, meditation. And the meditation India exported to Japan. And our, we have lost, we don't have any commodity left here, all sold out.
We'll import it.
Again. So, doing complete in awareness was the meditation practice called Zen Dhyana in India. That is sent there. And Japanese have incorporated in every aspect of their life. Every single aspect of their life, Zen is there. Now tell me one aspect of your life that Zen is there. And you people call yourself as Indians?
Gossip.
Gossip, okay. So bring awareness to whatever you do. Walk, talk, sit. Now you are sitting, okay? Just become aware that you are sitting. Please understand. Just become aware that you are sitting, right? I am aware. Just become aware that you are sitting. Feel the pressure of the buttock. Feel the hand, become aware that I am sitting, immediately you are moving towards the self. At any point of time you can go back to the self, the moment you become aware, I am sitting. You become aware that I am walking. You become aware that I am thinking. You become aware that I am doing something. Simply you go back to witness, awareness. For a moment, just become aware that you are sitting. See how what happens to the mind. Mind quiets. The mind is there only when you are unaware. The mind is your shadow. Mind has no reality. Mind is mind. The shadow called mind appears because you are not there. You have become unaware. Your attention has moved somewhere. Walk in awareness, talk in awareness, sleep in awareness. Whatever you do, do in awareness. That becomes meditation. Meditation doesn't mean just closing your eyes and sitting and sleeping or snoring. With snoring also, if you are aware that it is snoring, fine. Right? Am I clear? So this bring awareness to everything what you do. The mind becomes slowly, slowly, so silent and so peaceful, you become the embodiment of peace. How Japanese have imbibed our culture, you know. There was a tsunami attack in Japan. Many people lost their family life. And one Vietnamese monk was distributing the bread to the people. The people are standing in the queue at 6 o'clock in the night, evening. A big queue. A small boy, 8-year-old boy, was standing in the last at the end of the queue. The bread was getting over. Vietnamese monk called the small boy, "Boy, come here. The bread is getting over. Okay, take this bread and go." The boy just bowed down and said, "I don't want to take bread." The people in front of me, let them take. The bread will not be there. The boy said, "It's all right. I am the last." Okay. Then the Vietnamese monk asked him, "Where are your parents?" "My both parents are died in tsunami." The child is calm. The child is peaceful. Why? The culture of Zen. And we should be very proud that we taught Japanese Zen. And we should be very sad that we forgot what Zen is.
We have, sir.
Huh?
All these
are important. Okay? Every aspect of their culture they brought. Right? And to bring that Zen in woman and house, our people said, early in the morning you put rangoli. Right? Have you put rangoli in your life? A plastic sticker? You know why rangoli? The rangoli is a memory pattern in the memory. Visualize different patterns so that your mind becomes sharp, and while putting rangoli, entire attention is on rangoli. Not on the newspaper, not on the coffee, not on the children. Complete awareness in the design. Do you do that? Really? Japanese, the Buddhist monks, they put rangoli, very beautiful rangoli. It takes 6 months for them to do Kalachakra meditation. Very, very complex patterns, entirely in memory and entirely they do with color. Completely memory becomes sharp, attention becomes sharp, awareness becomes sharp. Tell me how many of you do really? This was the culture in India. This is how I lived. You watch the Japanese TV, not a single woman shouting, crying. Okay? Not a single, what I'm saying is depressed condition. People are walking calmly. Okay? The tsunami hit. The people who had not paid the hotel bill, they came, walked in, paid the bill. What happened to our culture? What happened to what we are doing? So bring awareness to what you do. Now let us do drak drishya meditation, fear seen. Close your eyes. Become aware of the environment. All around me, the wall is there, the hall is there. I am aware of the wall, I am consciousness. The wall is not aware of me, the wall is insentient, jada. I am Nanu Chaitanya. Gode Jada. Become aware of the body. The body is insentient Jada. I am aware of the body. I am Chaitanyam, consciousness. I am aware of the thoughts. Thoughts are not aware of me. Thoughts are inert. I am awareness. I am Chaitanyam. I am the witness. Any thought comes back? Understand it is Jada, insentient. Come back to yourself. Become aware of self. So now we'll come to the last prakriya of the day about thoughts. It's called vritti jnana prakriya. There are more prakriyas, but we can close it that day. So you have how many thoughts you have per day? Any idea? 60,000 thoughts are per day. And why these thoughts came?
Society
child. And I told you so many identities. Each identity pops up, creates one thought, leaves impression. Right? You take your roles, you become the roles. You play the role, no thoughts. The moment you become the role, impressions. Right? Thoughts are many. But how many thoughts you can have at a time? You can have only one thought at a time. There are no two thoughts.
What do you mean?
Thought itself is time. The time and space we are not taking right now. Thought is one thought at a time. Is it clear? Two thoughts you cannot have. Okay? So, one thought cannot know other thought. Because thought is an object, not a subject. Knower is I. So, suddenly one thought comes. Hey, since yesterday I am having this thought, yeah. Is it telling truth? How can one thought know about other thought? One thought cannot know about other thought because thought is jada, insentient. Okay? So a thought tells, since 10 days I am having this thought. The thought, there is a lie, false. Because a thought cannot know another thought. Right? No, I am remembering that since I am 10 days, I am having a thought. It's memory. Memory is another thought. No thoughts can remember or no other thought. Each thought is discrete. Each thought is object. One thought cannot know other thought. Thought appears and disappears. There are too many thoughts in my head. That's one thought. Which doesn't know any other thought. So thoughts are liars. The present moment is not a thought, okay? The present moment. Otherwise, memory, thoughts of memory, it's a continuous projection. So ignore the thoughts, be awareness, be in the present moment. Don't get distracted by thoughts. Go back always to the self. Okay? Now coming back to your made of your causality, question of causality, right? So what is your question, what is your interest in causality?
Karma, talking about karma in the morning.
Ah.
Am
I saying some sense?
Cause and effect.
Okay. So, first let me, the cause and effect is again concept in consciousness. Right? Let me give you an example. Okay? A mud pot is there. Okay? What is the cause and what is the effect?
What is the cause?
Huh? Mud is the cause?
Pot
is the effect?
Mud is the material cause.
Your concept of mud and pot is the cause. A child looks at the pot. Does he see pot or mud?
Pot.
He just sees mud in a form. But you give a name called pot. And you find a cause called mud. The cause and effect is caused by your consciousness. Concept. You understand? You give a sequencing of events and say, see the mud pot, oh, the mud was there and became pot. Actually, only mud is there in that form in front of you. The sequencing is called cause and effect. For example, let's say, do you read newspaper, sir?
Sir, can you start from the scientific side, sir?
Science, I don't understand, sir. I have no clue what is science is all about. We'll come to that. Are Baba, I don't understand what scientists are saying. Okay, first I'll tell you what I know. So, do you read newspaper, sir?
Yes.
What newspaper? Do you read Deccan Herald really? Do you really? Huh? You read what?
Deccan
Herald. You read Deccan Herald newspaper. Sure?
Hindu.
The news in the paper or newspaper, what you read? There is a paper in the background and you read the news. You don't need to read the newspaper. You read the news and you ignore the paper behind, right? You have never seen the paper there, always you see the news only. Very interesting, hot political news. Right? You ignore the paper. So is paper there in the behind? Paper is there. So you never read newspaper in your life, you read only news. In the paper also you don't know. So like that, consciousness is all pervading all the time. And our attention is focused on spicy objects. Right?
Consciousness is paper.
Paper. So now, what is this paper? So what is this?
Paper.
A rocket. Now, is it rocket? It is a paper. Nothing has become rocket. A form is changed and name is given. Now what is the cause and what is effect? Is there a cause and effect now? Has paper become rocket?
It can fly.
It can fly. There is a form. There is a function. Right? Form and function and name. There are three. But nothing has happened to the paper. Paper is the cause, rocket is the effect. But nothing has happened to the cause. Effect is appearance only in the form of form, function and name. Is it right? So paper is still there, nothing has happened to the paper. Like the consciousness only takes the form, function and name in the form of objects. So what is the cause and what is the effect now? Madam? See, the cause and effect we are associating, when we speak of cause and effect, we are only looking at it from the object point of view. Right? The object is, let's say, there are two pen. I hit, there is a sound which has come out. So, hitting is the cause, sound is the effect. Right? We are saying that. There's a cause and effect, or we are saying sequence. But what you don't realize, okay, there is no cause and effect here. So, hitting, sound. So, you generate two thoughts. And these two thoughts give a sequencing, cause and effect. In reality, at any point of time, your attention is only one. You heard the sound. Okay? That's one thought. That's the present moment. That's the reality. Then you remember that hitting happened. Past. It's a memory thought. So you are comparing the unreal with the real and saying there's a cause and effect. Right? Anything you pick up from the memory is not in the present moment. Present moment, cause and effect are simultaneously happening. Got it? Everything is happening in consciousness in simultaneously now. But our mind splits it. The cause and effect is unreal. It's a sequencing done by the thought. In the consciousness, cause and effect both exist simultaneously. There's no cause and effect, only consciousness is there. So, let us... Yes, sir. You need one more example? Cause and effect? What? I'll give another example, okay? So I'm wearing a, what is this called? Kurta. Right? I am wearing a kurta. Is it reality?
No, sir.
It's not. So what I am wearing? So the kurta is a name and form. Agreed? Name and form and function. Right? Name and form and function has a utility. It's useful. Right? The kurta is made up of fabric. Right? Kurta is made up of fabric. So kurta is mithya, fabric is satya. Because without fabric, kurta cannot be there. What is the cause and what is the effect? Without fabric, the kurta cannot exist. That's kurta is mithya, fabric is satya. Relatively unreal. Okay? Fabric is relatively real. Is fabric kurta?
No.
So, the kurta, which is name, form and function, is made up of something called non-kurta. A non-kurta called fabric makes something called kurta called fabric. Kurta. It means a kurta is made up of non-kurta. Right? Got the logic? So what has changed here? Only naming. Only conceptual changes happened. Name and form. Okay, fabric, what is made up of?
Yeah.
Cotton. Cotton is not fabric. So fabric is made up of something which is not fabric. It's called cotton. So kurta is made up of not kurta. Not kurta is made up of not fabric. And what has happened between only giving name and shape? You keep on giving names, right? So, what cotton is made up of? Plant material. Plant material is neither kurta, nor fabric, nor cotton. So, everything is made up of not that. And if you finally go, it will come to atoms. Atoms are not fabric, not kurta, not cotton. Atoms. What are atoms are made up of? Atoms are made up of not atoms called concept. What is not atom called concept? Concept is made up of consciousness. So everything is made up of consciousness only. And everything else is a name and form, keep on giving name and form, which is the job of the mind. Now what is the cause and effect?
Reason.
Shiva and Shakti. Because we learn words, we are doing it. Shiva and Shakti.
Is there a cause and effect? What is the cause and what is the effect?
It's all created by mind.
It's created by the mind. Reality, there is only consciousness.
Correct.
That is called Sarvam Kaluida Brahma. All this is Brahman. And this naming and forming is called Maya Brahma. So two monks were going, one flag was fluttering. So one monk said, flag is fluttering. Now other monk said, the wind is making flag flutter. The cause is the wind, flag flutter is effect. Right? The guru came, idiots. Neither flag is fluttering nor wind is blowing. Your mind is fluttering. Did you get that, madam? Huh? So flag is fluttering, one monk says. Now wind is making flag flutter, another monk says. They are arguing which is cause and which is effect. The monk, senior monk comes and says, hey, idiots, neither flag is fluttering nor wind is blowing. Your mind is spinning. Like ultimately it boils down to consciousness. When you go to consciousness, there's no cause, there's no effect. No. Mind is present from sense organs. The consciousness perceptions rise. This will be another class of perception.
Through this, all this.
So that's a concept keep rising, and this concept gives a feeling of cause and effect. Concept gives a feeling of the world. Everything is made up of consciousness. There is nothing called matter. So there is nothing called science. Because science is the study of matter, and what is there is consciousness only. Then whatever you conclude is also in the domain of mithya. It's useful. Okay, coffee is H2 only, it's useful, but it's H2O. Okay, let's close for the day. Any questions?
Sir, how did applied science and technology
change? Sir, I can keep on talking. People are already getting ready for coffee. So let us close with the prayer. Just prayer, okay?